y'all, it's Kathleen Mooney with EIEIO's Organic Farm in Wimberley for Tuesday Tips from the Farm. This week I'm going to be talking to y'all about selecting fruit trees, how to plant them, and how to nourish them throughout the year so they can nourish you. Some people are a little scared about planting fruit trees or a little hesitant, but we know what I say to that. Don't be a chicken and grow a pear. Right now I'm at my local nursery. It is the middle of fall and the best time to plant fruit trees in Texas. Okay, let's head on over to the fruit tree selection. By planting your trees in the fall, this allows them to have just enough time for their roots to become established, getting them adjusted to the new soil that they're going to be growing in, and also prepare them for the fast growth the following year. Fruit trees are a valuable addition for those of us trying to be more responsible and grow our own foods. But it is so worth it. With a minimal effort, you will have fruit for years and years to come. Be sure to select fruit trees that are hardy and tolerant for your zone. Right here in Central Texas, we're zone 9, so you want to keep that in mind as you're selecting your fruit trees. Another thing to think about is the chill hours. There's a map online that you can go to, but it'll tell you how many chill hours your specific area had last winter, and you can kind of go by that. I know that my area where I am, we're in a deep valley here in Wimberley. So we have like somewhere above 600 chill hours, whereas a lot of people only have 300 chill hours. If I plant something that needs at least 400 chill hours and my property has 600 chill hours, no problem. But if I plant something that needs 600 chill hours and it only gets 400, therein lies a problem. Seems to me the buzz this year is all about the La Feliciana and the La Festival. Here at my local nursery, they have some La Felicianas. They require 500 chill hours. I get 600, no problem. I'm good to go with the La Feliciana. So let's look at them. Of these three that they have in stock today, I'm gonna go with this one right here. This one to me is gonna require more pruning next spring. It's got all these little buds coming up here. This one already has a branch coming out this way. It's healthy. It doesn't have any shoots down the stalk. This one's nice too, and it actually might even have some buds going on, which is not good. So that's the reason why I'm not picking this. I won't be pruning it until January or February. That's a whole nother video that we won't have till January. Now another thing you want to think about is how old the tree is. Because peach trees usually don't start producing very well until their third, usually fourth year. These trees that they're selling today are all 2 years old. That gives me a year's head start. I plant a 2 year old tree, I'm guaranteed to have some fruit within a couple summers, and that's pretty cool. Okay, now peach trees are self-pollinating, so you don't need to worry about them, but pear trees pollinate, they need bees or another pear. So if you're gonna plant pear trees, plant two together and they will help each other pollinate. So today I'm going to get two peach trees, two pear trees, and two plum trees. And it has to be two different varieties. They have an Asian pear and they also have what looks to be gorgeous, a moon glow pear. So that's two different types of pears. Okay, so we started the farm 12 years ago and I ended up in a nursery in San Antonio that encouraged me to buy a bunch of different kinds of apple trees. Boy, was I excited. Who don't like a fresh apple picking one right off the tree? Well, it didn't work out that way. And here's what I got after 11 years of taking care of these apple trees. Well, I'm gonna go home and plant these trees. I always plant my trees the same day I bought them. It reduces the stress on them. Occasionally, you'll buy a tree. It's probably a year to 2 years old. They produce for you the first year. Then the next year, they don't. But they are still establishing themselves below, or you don't have enough pollination going on. There are kind of a number of factors, but it all varies on so many things. The condition of the soil, the weather, the over-fertilization or under-fertilization. There's so many different factors, or if you pruned them too hard, or didn't prune them at all, that's more likely. So just plant them. Enjoy their beauty. They're gonna put up a huge canopy eventually and you're gonna get fruit from them that's so fresh and exciting to eat. Another tip, if you wanna look back on my other video, I talked about companion planting. Well, underneath fruit trees, I always like to plant cilantro. You can plant all sorts of different herbs underneath your fruit trees, and they benefit the fruit tree. You'll get a higher yield off the fruit tree over the course of time. Now, a lot of these herbs are going to be annuals, so you replant them. But I'm tell you what, I have had my cilantro go a lot longer when I plant it on the row with fruit trees, because they get the shade from the fruit tree, and the cilantro can keep going and it doesn't bolt like early June because it has shade. I remember the first year I planted a fig tree and it lost all its leaves, and I was like, oh no, I lost it. What did I do wrong? But they're deciduous. They drop their leaves. Then they come back the next year full tilt. So don't worry about it. A way to also check and see if a tree is still alive, I took my thumbnail and I scratched it down here just a teeny bit, and look how green that is. So although it had lost all of its leaves, I knew it was still alive. A couple other trees that a lot of people like to plant, I have not tried it, but persimmon do really well in zone 9. And also pomegranate. Pomegranate does really well if you plant right now in our area. So try those if you like that fruit. Seems to me like a lot of society today is all geared up for instant gratification. And that can be challenging. I mean, the dopamine's fun and everything, but with fruit trees, it is not instant. It takes time and patience and nurturing, but that's a virtue I'd like to develop. Imagine, I'm gonna plant this peach tree and I can almost already smell the peach pie. I can almost already taste the plum jam when I plant the plum tree I'm about to show y'all, or make the nutmeg pear preserves with the pear tree I'm about to buy. It is so worth it, because over the years, you have patience at the beginning, but over the years, it will continue to bear fruit for you. And think about this, when you buy fruit at the grocery store, it's come from God only knows how far away, in a refrigerated truck. You pick a pear or a peach or a plum off one of your trees, it is so nourishing. They say that the highest nutritional value in any vegetable or fruit is within the first 72 hours of harvesting, and that's what's gonna happen with all your fruit. Now I'm gonna show you how to plant the tree, and I wanna remind y'all that fall is the very best time to plant fruit trees in Texas. Number one, it's not as hot. There's cooler temperatures, so the tree doesn't go through as much stress. And number two, it requires less watering usually. So they're gonna adapt to their new soil and situation a whole lot quicker. Okay, when I buy a fruit tree, a lot of times from the nursery, go ahead and pull out these extra little weeds. No sense in planting them with it. Okay, so I've cleaned it up. And now what you do, you don't wanna over-fertilize the tree. So I've dug a deep, deep hole. I'm gonna mix it half compost and half the dirt that was there. I'm gonna take this little tree and I'm gonna push the sides of it like this. I'm gonna push it, push it, push it. This will help it be able to gently come out of the bucket. Okay, I'm gonna take it like this, shake the bucket, and voila, here's the tree. If you remember some of my other videos, planting by the moon cycle, I always try to loosen up the roots at the bottom by working those roots and loosening them up. That way they'll spread quicker. Put the tree in the hole. Now I'm gonna loosen up some of the dirt on the top. But see this little couple shoots that are coming out from this tree? There's like three of them. Those are called suckers. And you wanna go ahead and cut those off. So now I've got it right here in the middle, and I'm gonna fill the hole halfway with a half, little bit of half compost and a little bit of half dirt. And now when it's not full, when it's half full, I'm gonna get a hose and I'm gonna water for about 5 minutes. I'm gonna water this root ball. Even though I bought it wet, like I suggested earlier, you always buy a moist one at the nursery. Really good. I'm gonna make circles around it to get all that compost and soil wet too. Give it a nice pool of water to sit in. How far away? You can see right over there is a little pear tree that I planted last year. It's exactly 15 feet from this new one. So that's about the distance you wanna have them. The next thing I'm gonna do is fill in the hole with the rest of the dirt that I pulled out in the first place. last but not least, I'm going to cover this. You can cover it with either straw or mulch or leaves. Okay, now notice I'm not watering it again because I've already watered the root bulb. So you don't need to water it anymore after you've covered it with dirt. You're just going to cover all this with a bunch of leaves. Hold in the moisture and then you take off the tag. And remember, it takes a lot of patience, but in about 2 years maybe, I'm going to be making nutmeg pear preserves. I can see it and smell it now. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe. Check out our YouTube channel. There's a lot more farming tip videos on there. And we'll see you next week for more Tuesday tips from the farm. Happy planting!